Well, the final results are in for Yukon's election. It's a full week now after voters went to the polls. And the outcome, well, it all came down to luck and a draw.
Annie Blake.
There it was. And there she is, the winner, NDP candidate Annie Blake, winning in the northernmost riding in the territory, her name drawn from that box, after she and the incumbent Liberal candidate, they were still tied, even after a vote recount. Steve Silva is with us in Whitehorse this morning. Normally, well, always reading the news there for CBC Whitehorse, but happy to have you with us this morning, Steve. This sounds like an unusual situation, drawing lots essentially to decide a winner. Tell us more about this.
Yeah, well, on election day, there was a tie. It happened in the riding of Vuntut Gwitchin. It's in northern Yukon. And it was between incumbent Liberal Pauline Frost and the NDP's Annie Blake. They tied with 78 votes each. Now, when there's a tie, that can lead to a recount, and that's what Elections Yukon requested through the Supreme Court of Yukon yesterday. So that was held yesterday, and afterwards, there was still a tie. So that led to what's known as a drawing of lots. And what that entails, at least in this context, was what you saw on the screen a little earlier. Essentially, there was a box, they put two ballots in there, picked it out, and there you go. That's the MLA. So it's a bit of an unusual situation, of course, but it's not unprecedented. This has happened in Yukon multiple times before. And what is notable is that Annie Blake, the NDP candidate who won, she beat out the incumbent Liberal, Pauline Frost, who had also been the health minister here in Yukon for several years, including throughout the entire pandemic so far. We spoke with both Frost and Blake a little after the winner was announced. Take a look.
I feel that the democratic process has been followed, and I think it's timely that we just give ourselves space to start moving forward in a good way as a community.
I wouldn't say I'm disappointed. I would say you define a winner by what, right? You define a winner by what you've done. I would say that I've won and gained a lot of respect from Yukoners and those individuals in my community.
The reaction from Pauline Frost, as you say, Steve, the outgoing health minister for the territory. So it'll be a big change in the territorial government. So interesting. It is that draw that settled things in that particular riding, but there's another tie that looms over the entire territorial government.
Yeah, so at the end of election night, the Liberals, the incumbent Liberals, they lost their majority government and ended up with 8 seats, as did the Yukon Party. And so that means the Liberals did not pick up this seat. The Yukon Party and the Liberals are still tied with 8 seats each. And it's the NDP with 3 seats that now holds the balance of power. Now, the funny thing is, regardless of this, regardless of the NDP picking up this seat and Liberals being tied, by convention, ultimately, the Liberal government gets to have the first crack at forming government. And that is what the Liberal Party says it plans to do when that time comes. So, in a way, this loss doesn't actually change what's expected to be the final result here.
But it still is a very interesting story. And Steve Silva, thank you for telling us about it this morning live from Whitehorse.